What's up, you guys?
Let's
Welcome
go.
back. Today's video, Josh really is just here for moral support on
I'm
this
video. I'm honestly just here to listen because I want to learn,
Actually,
although I was there during the process.
Yeah, I want to hear your input on all these questions. So today we're going to be talking about basically working out while being pregnant and then how to get back in shape postpartum. So all things pregnancy.
8 months postpartum right here. And Katie B, I just want to say she's been crushing it.
Thanks,
all
babe.
Pregnancy long, she was crushing it. And then obviously after having a baby, with having things stitched up and all that going on down there.
First
still
thing,
got after it.
I do have to say is this is a disclaimer. Obviously, I do not know everything. This is just from my, what I think I know.
She's giving her personal experience.
Yeah.
Everybody is different. Everybody's body is different. Everybody copes in different ways and everything. So this is her personal experience.
And I also want to say, don't compare yourself to other people. Don't be like, oh, well, Katie did this. Why can't I? Because it's like, everyone is different. But if you do look at it as like, Katie did this, I can do that too. That's a good, healthy
mindset.
You have to have
healthy
a good
mindset.
Don't compare yourself to other people, but you can, be inspired by people.
We're going to get a little citrus blast to get the vlog started.
Oh.
Are you guys ready? If you guys want to check out any of the First Form products, we're going to leave a link down below. And
speaking of First Form products, I know a lot of people might be like, well, how can you take supplements while you're, pregnant? And the thing is, obviously you can't have, energy drinks and
consult
things
your
like
doctors
that.
About that information.
Yeah, consult your doctors about that. But you can take their, First Form does have prenatals that are really good. So they have prenatals and, we'll link those.
First question, let's go.
Anyway, how did I work out while being pregnant? Because I know a lot of people are very controversial about this. You can't work out while you're pregnant. First things first, talk to your doctor. Second, my doctor said that
all
I
of these
do...
questions are going to start with the consult your doctor first. But obviously,
just put that out
so
there.
We did that.
Yeah, you can work out while you're pregnant. There's honestly only a few workouts I couldn't do while
so
I was
our
pregnant.
Doctor told us that Katie can do any. She shouldn't be taking on any extra. She's never ran a marathon before. She shouldn't all of a sudden run a marathon while she's pregnant.
But honestly, I still feel like if I trained for it the properly way, because I train like that all the time, then I'd be able
Katie
to.
Katie runs a lot and stuff, and she did run, I'm pretty sure 8 miles was the furthest she went while being pregnant.
And I also think.
But you run a lot. That's normal. You're not doing anything out of the ordinary.
Yeah, but I think even if you didn't work out a ton, and let's say you want to stay in shape, I still think you can go for long walks. You can slowly work out. Just don't go crazy.
No, 100%. I would assume if you never worked out before and then you got pregnant and you're now it's my time to start my fitness journey, you could absolutely
do that.
But obviously you probably wouldn't just go into running 8 miles. But Katie's been doing that, so that was fine for her. But
just don't be an extremist. That's it.
Yeah, exactly.
And then, next question. What type of workouts did you do? So I actually followed we have a Move app, and basically I did all the follow-on workouts with it. I did all the workouts I did before, and there was only a few things I have to alternate.
Yeah.
I wouldn't do burpees because I wouldn't lay on my stomach. In the beginning,
obviously,
you can, but once you get a bump and stuff, you don't want to be laying on your stomach. I still would do push-ups. I didn't do pull-ups. Because I read something that, and my doctor said maybe not do pull-ups. So there was only a few things I could do. I did work out abs, and that is one thing that I feel like while I was pregnant, I still did abs. There was certain ab movements that I didn't do. Again, you'll just have to figure out what works for you. But I do think that working out my abs while I was pregnant made my abs more fit after.
Yeah.
And they really helped me bounce back quick.
I will say,
because I never lost my core
after pregnancy,
strength.
I feel like you look more toned than almost before, which is crazy.
I almost agree, because I think it's because I was working out while I was pregnant and doing all the core. And I think it just helped me a lot. But okay, next question. What athletic clothes did you wear? And then I also wanted to say something. Someone said, is JD Fit coming out with maternity? So, question number one is, I actually did wear a lot of JD Fit clothing. There was certain things I couldn't wear, and then certain things I just sized up.
Yeah.
So I did wear a lot of our spandex because they're super stretchy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I pretty much wore JD Fit up until
KDB, she was rocking sports bra and spandex.
The Heat Wave collection, remember?
Because it was high once you
the
was
jumpsuits.
Pregnant.
So you still can wear athletic clothing that isn't maternity, but a lot of people have been asking for JD Fit maternity. Maybe we'll have to do that, in the future. Maybe we're working on something.
We might be working on something.
We might be.
Well, hint, hint.
Yeah. Okay. Next one. This is a pretty big one when it comes to being pregnant and eating and I think you have to have a healthy mindset when you're pregnant, because at first when I was pregnant, I was well, I'm pregnant, I'm just gonna eat whatever, like, I'm pregnant, my body needs this, like,
that's... This was my most sad thing about KDB being pregnant, is I was expecting the most outrageous food cravings ever, and, like, her wanting to get dessert every single night, and I was so down for it.
And
but props to her for, you know, like, being like, hey, like, yeah, I'm pregnant. Like, that stuff sounds good, but, like, I'm not craving it.
Like, yeah. For me, at first, I was like, oh, like, whatever, I'm pregnant, I'm gonna eat whatever, I'm gonna do whatever. And then I started noticing, I felt, like, very, like, just not happy.
Sluggish.
Like, very sluggish. I felt, like, not too confident. I kind of felt, like, puffy and bloated. And, like, then, like, my confidence was, like, kind of dwindling back. And I was like, wait a minute, I don't want to be, like, not confident while I'm pregnant. And that doesn't mean you have to be, like, shredded and fit while you're pregnant. It's just, like, when you're not feeding yourself good food and when you're not moving as much, for me personally, I don't feel as confident.
For us, fitness has always been about moving and feeling good about ourselves. Like, I feel like a lot of people look at fitness like, oh, I gotta look a certain way in this. Like,
or, oh, they care so much about what they been, look like.
Like, our fitness journey has always been, like, we do it for...
Like, mental health?
Mental health, feeling good, feeling confident. So that's what I would say about her fitness journey while she was pregnant. It's like, obviously your body's gonna change. Like, yeah. That's without question. But to her, and I know she says this all the time, is like, first of all, when she moves, she feels better. She feels good about herself. She's
feel
more
bloated,
energetic.
I feel energetic. I feel like
confident.
Happy and confident. And
like,
then,
what? On top of it, accomplishing a workout, just in general, you feel good about yourself. But now, when you're pregnant and
you're
doing it,
like,
you're just doing like another barrier. You probably feel so much better.
It,
I mean,
it does. That I will say, like, when I was pregnant working out, it's like you just get this extra confidence boost. You're like, I am pregnant and I'm working out. Like, what?
I would look at
what
her.
Else can I not do in the day? You're like, I can do anything.
Yeah. You feel like a superwoman, probably. Like,
no,
I would look at her and be like, I'm struggling doing this workout, and like, she's pregnant. She's like 7 months pregnant. She's crushing it. She's got a baby inside of her.
For other people too.
Yeah.
But the thing
is, it's cool
to
be a leader.
I realized when I switched my mindset of like, I'm pregnant, I'm gonna eat whatever I want, do whatever I want, from like, wait, I'm pregnant, I wanna feel my best and take this in and enjoy it. So like, I don't wanna feel like insecure during my pregnancy. I don't wanna feel like a sluggish and no energy based off what I'm eating. So when I switched my mindset, I didn't even, it's not like I was like, oh, I'm only eating healthy food. I'm gonna work out like crazy. It literally just gave me a goal to stay fit during my pregnancy, which made me happy to work towards a goal. And then also when it came to like desserts and things like that, I made like different alternatives. Like, so like at night, Josh would have like a cookie skillet. And instead of just having a cookie skillet every night, I was like, I still need a treat. I'm not gonna take away like having a sweet treat, but then I would have like a healthier like fruit bar or something like that, like a popsicle. So it's like, you know, less junk food. And then I also kind of switched my mindset of like, I'm just gonna feed myself whatever I want to like, what am I putting in my body for the baby? And like that helped me eat a lot healthier too.
Right.
Because it wasn't even at that point about me. It was kind of like, well, is it worth it?
What's gonna be the best for
you know?
The baby?
Yeah, so.
And I personally think if you are able to do some kind of movement and stuff while you're pregnant, that probably is good for the baby too. And I'm no doctor or anything, but you know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah. No, I think that's really good.
To be moving and stuff.
Well, I also think too, if you're someone who's not really into working out and that's just not your desire, that I still think that you can like have like a daily walking goal. I think it's really good to just be moving. It doesn't even have to be like fitness like that. Like it literally could be just like you have a goal of walking 2 miles a day. And I know sometimes your feet can hurt when you're pregnant. I actually had someone reach out to me and they were like, my feet just hurt too bad. And I was like, what shoes are you wearing? And then I put them on to wearing Hokas and they're like, wait, I can walk now. I feel so good.
Really?
So make sure you have good walking shoes, especially when you're pregnant because your feet will swell up. So just a daily movement goal, I think is really important. Next question. I guess that really kind of wraps everything up with during pregnancy. Now let's talk about postpartum. Ooh. I will say postpartum was harder to work out once I was cleared than when I was pregnant.
Why do you say that?
Because I took such a long break. So that just showed me how important it is to stay consistent in what you're doing. So obviously I had my baby and then I couldn't work out for 6 weeks. And I kind of took that pretty seriously. I would like do like a little workout at like 4 weeks, but like it really wasn't anything much of a workout. So I kind of had to wait because I did have a fourth degree tear. And So I waited. And then when I was trying to get back at it, it was a little discouraging because it was so hard. It felt like I hadn't worked out in years. But I think the thing is to just use that workout and don't have the mindset of like, oh my God, I gotta look like how I did before I have the baby. Do it as like, oh my God, I like need a mental break from the baby. Like I'm gonna listen to my favorite music, my favorite podcast. I'm gonna get some me time. And like 100%. If you switch your mindset from like, I wanna look good to I'm gonna take this time and like work on myself and do something for me. Because as a mom, I feel like all you're doing in the newborn stage of life is like taking care of someone else. Like you don't get sleep. You're feeding them. Like all you're doing is keeping that human alive. It's like take care of yourself and take working out as your time. If you can switch that mindset.
It's like your little therapy session, you know?
And even if it's just going for a walk and listening to a podcast, like
hot girl walk.
Hot girl walk.
Hot
like
mom walk.
Take that time for yourself. Which I think just switching the mindset really helps. But I will say it was hard getting back into it. Like I went for a run and I was like, my God, I felt like I was going so fast. And look at the time, it was like 9:30, and that's a good running time. But normally I go a lot quicker than that. So like for me, it wasn't as good.
Right.
And I was like, wait, what the heck? That was so hard. But just give yourself grace. And it is funny because I also feel like it gives you a lot of confidence. Like after when you work out during your pregnancy, I feel like you do bounce back a lot quicker. But I think it's always good to not have that mindset of like, I need to bounce back, but rather than like, I just need to take care of myself.
Yeah, I was gonna say for me, it's never like a, oh, like bounce back thing or like look a certain way. It's just like, you're just doing it to feel the best, feel the most confident.
Yeah. For yourself, not for other people, not so other people are like, oh, she's so fit, she's so this. It's like, it's for you, because when you feel confident in your own skin, I just feel like you have so much more availability to like pour into other people's lives rather than to just feel, I don't know, I feel like insecurities can cause a lot of issues in relationships, friendships. So I feel like when you can be your confident self, in whatever way you can do that, you're just gonna be like a better
person. And you have the biggest motivator in your life now, you know, if you're a new parent, you have a child, so that's the biggest motivator to me, at least, being a dad. I'm sure it's the same being a mom, but now you want to be the best version of yourself, not just for you, like
just had a good
all
example.
28 years of my life before we had a kid, like, I wanted to be the best version of myself for myself, but now it's even more motivation, like, I want to set the best example for my daughter, so.
And that actually reminds me, I kind of wanted to talk about, like, what it looks like to work out when you have a baby, or, like, when times get really tough, because obviously, like, everyone's circumstances are different, but there's times when Josh is, like, gone, and I was taking care of Sky all by myself, and I wanted to work out, and sometimes it looks really different. Like every day, you just have to go in with open mindset. Like she might have lose it in the middle of my workout, and my workout might get cut short, and that's okay. But then like later, either continue picking it back up, or like always retrying to work out again.
Yeah.
So just being okay with like, don't just give up on the fact like if your baby starts losing and your workout gets cut short, that you can never work out with a baby because it's just impossible. Because some days it will be possible and some days you just have to be okay with the workout getting cut short.
Yeah, and so, it all
open mindset.
It's that I feel like that's everything with the baby, honestly. Yeah. It's just being open to the unknown. You know, you go to a restaurant, the baby starts crying, like, you know.
You might have to leave, or you might have to
hold the baby while you eat your food. You know, everything's different, so you're just figuring out a new way to do things.
Exactly. So. Okay, another tip I have for you guys is especially while you're pregnant, and I know they weigh you all the time, is to not really focus on the number on the scale, because like I remember like when I was pregnant too, there were so many like older moms who would be like, I only gained 20 pounds when I was pregnant. I only gained this much. And like everyone always like says that as like a weird like, I don't know if it's supposed to be like, I was so skinny while I was pregnant, but I actually got that comment all the time. And at first I was like, wait, I think I'm gaining way more than 20 pounds. Like, I feel like I like, I was like, I felt so lean and so good in my own skin. Like I felt like, I mean, I was running, I was working out so hard during my pregnancy, and I'm pretty sure I probably at least like, I gained like, not like a lot of weight, but like way more than 20 pounds. And I was like, and I just kept thinking, I'm like, how are these people saying they're gaining 20 pounds when I'm working out so hard?
First of all, the numbers on the scale never matter, you know? It's more so you know, about how you feel and everything. But
I always thought that was interesting, and that made me remind myself. I was like, oh, I mean, it really doesn't matter. That's an older
generation thing. It honestly.
Is. And I was like, I don't really think it matters how much weight I'm gaining, because whatever I'm gaining, the baby needs, right?
100%.
All you can do is focus on doing the best choices for yourself. Not oh, the number on the scale is going up, because obviously you're pregnant, you're growing a human inside you. And guess what? The crazy thing is people would always say that, and I'm like, I'm pretty sure like I gained like, I mean, I don't want to say a number because I could be way wrong, but like way over 20 pounds, like over 30 pounds, like over more than that. And to me, I was like, that doesn't really mean anything, because that doesn't mean it's your body fat. That doesn't mean anything. I was like, you have like all the fluid inside of you. Like someone might carry more fluid than the next person. So I thought that was very interesting. And it reminded me, I was like, I think girls are so bad, and I think the younger generation is so much better, like my age and younger, about not weighing ourselves and not caring so much about like how much the scale says versus like how you feel. Because to me, the scale means nothing when you're going off of like body fat and things like that, like how you feel. But I just think when you're pregnant, you're already kind of like, your body's changing. Don't make it harder on yourself and focus on that number on the scale, because
100%.
Why do that to yourself? Okay, last question. It said, did you guys, or not you guys, but did you take any supplements after? And I actually did, but obviously, like I said, consult with your doctor. That was one thing I missed so bad while I was pregnant, was drinking energy drinks, which speaking of, I'm taking a sip of Joshy B's.
Catherine McKinley. We share everything, but energy drinks, nah, this is all
talking
mine.
To someone when I take his. But no, so I actually, as soon as I was not pregnant anymore, I was like, give me the first form energy drink. I was like, give me the amino acids. And yeah, I just, a lot of supplements that I did take.
Came back to the pre-workout parties.
Yeah, supplements help me, I feel like, get excited about working out too. They give me that extra motivation. So if you guys want the extra motivation, like again, we talk about First Form all the time because we genuinely love the company. And we're actually going there soon, so we're very excited to go back.
Back to St. Louis.
And it's just a really cool company. I feel like they have so many different products that fit our everyday life, from energy drinks to our protein bars, to the protein sticks, to our amino acids that we drink at night, all our vitamins, like literally everything. Your clothing that you're wearing right now.
No, I know.
Literally. No. But anyway, make sure you guys check them out if you guys want that extra.
We'll leave our favorites down below that you guys can check out. But
yeah, also the last thing I just want to say is, remember, like, you're only on this fitness journey and this journey for you. So don't compare yourself to other people, and just try and do whatever's going to make you happiest in your own skin. Because I think every single woman who's bringing a baby, especially, I mean, every woman in general is amazing and beautiful. But the fact that if you are taking and creating life with someone else and bringing another human into this world, be gentle on yourself. You know, like your body is going through so much, and you will have so much time to get to where you want to be. So don't put that too much like pressure on yourself or anything like
100%.
That. 100%. But we love you guys. We hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll see you guys in the next video.